Welcome back to the videos on the perovskite PV technology. Another very important challenge is that perovskite solar cells suffer from degradation of the performance in time. This graph shows the normalized performance of a typical perovskite solar cell in ambient air in time. The efficiency almost drops to 0% in only 40 hours. This effect cannot be reversed with a thermal anneal. So the effect is different from, for instance, the Stabler-Wronsky effect in amorphous silicon solar cells, which is referred to as metastable effect, as it can be recovered under a thermal anneal. If the same experiment is repeated here in dry air or in a nitrogen atmosphere, the degradation is delayed. This demonstrates that humidity plays an important role and suggests that the effect is a chemical instability. The perovskite materials can be decomposed when exposed to humidity. The presence of water can accelerate the chemical degradation of the perovskite phase under illumination and heat. The structure of the lattice can be significantly modified. The lead atom and the two iodine atoms form a molecule that becomes an interstitial entity in the lattice, deteriorating the electro-optical properties of the materials. Here you see some examples of the paper of Habes-Seutinger on how the color and transparency of the samples can change over time. In addition, some electron materials such as aluminium or silver could react with perovskites in a moisture environment as well. Finally, some halite perovskite materials can spontaneously decompose under relatively moderate temperatures. Several approaches have been explored to prevent the degradation of perovskite solar cells. Here I will discuss a limited selection of these solutions. One solution is the encapsulation of the perovskite cell structure without the inclusion of any water in the cell. In the picture, you can see that some structures are more resistant against water than others. A challenge in this approach is that encapsulate materials with a sufficient high water barrier that can guarantee a long lifetime of the cell structure are rare. If they exist, these encapsulate materials are not cost-effective yet. An alternative approach is to modify the nature of the lattice itself to make the material more resistant against the presence of water. It has been demonstrated that the halite perovskite materials with a mixture of various cations and halite ions can significantly delay or remove the chemical degradation. The excation can be a mixture of organic and inorganic materials like cesium, rubidium, methyl ammonium, and the formamidnium. The halite anion can be a mixture of iodine and bromine. Improved stability and efficiency have been demonstrated in which the efficiency only shows a relative degradation of a few percent in 1,000 hours. However, it has to be addressed that stability studies are usually performed over a period of 1,000 hours. Chemical instabilities like bulk oxidation occur on longer time scales before the detrimental effects become visible. The record conversion efficiency of perovskite solar cells that is certified is equal to 19.7%. In literature, efficiencies of perovskite solar cells are reported just over an efficiency of 22%. These are promising results if you consider that this material has been studied only for less than a decade. The first small modules based on glass encapsulation and flexible foil have been demonstrated. However, the efficiency significantly dropped in reference to the record lab-scale devices with sizes in the order of a square millimeter. Nevertheless, the instability problems pose a very crucial challenge that needs to be tackled before this PV technology can be successfully and commercially scaled up. Another interesting application of the halite perovskites is that they are being explored as a potential top junction in combination with a crystalline silicon bottom junction in a high-efficient tandem solar cell. We'll discuss the hybrid structures in the last week of PV2X. In summary, for photovoltaics, organic inorganic perovskites are used. In these perovskites, the large cation A is organic and often methyl ammonium is used. X is a halogen such as iodine, chlorine or bromine, often in a mixed halide material. The cation B usually contains lead, while tin can be used as well. The direct band gap and electrical properties of the halide perovskites make it an ideal material for thin film PV technologies. We have discussed the various device structures like mesoporous, regular planar and the inverted planar configuration. The challenges of the PV technology and potential solutions for the perovskite PV technologies have been discussed as well, like the hysteresis effect and the degradation of the performance due to humidity. Record efficiencies on lab scale up to 22% have been demonstrated. Next week, we will look at the application of perovskites as topsail in the combination with a crystalline silicon solar cell in a so-called tandem solar cell. So, see you next week!